What are your thoughts about Chainlink and hybrid smart contracts that utilize off-chain external data sources?
And I think it's definitely necessary for smart contracts that do a lot of things to use off-chain data of some kind, right? Like if you want to have a stable coin, you need a price oracle so you know what price you're targeting. If you want to have some fancy, you know, crop insurance gadget, like I think EtherRisk has been doing a lot of good work with that in, I think it was either Kenya or Sri Lanka or both. Like they're making a lot of good progress in some of those places. Like you need some kind of oracle to tell you, you know, did it actually rain in this particular area? Mm-hmm. If you want to have like assets that mirror other financial assets, you need an oracle. If you want to have a prediction market, you need an oracle. And so projects that provide oracles are definitely really important. I mean, there are definitely different kinds of use cases. Like Augur is more about, you know, events, and the Augur Oracle is designed, like, I think, differently from Chainlink, right? Like Chainlink emphasizes the whole, you know, like we have a fast automated thing that just like gives you data quickly. Whereas Augur is more, you know, we don't give a crap about speed. And look, we don't need to give a crap about speed, because if you want to get your money out on a prediction market that where in reality it's resolved, you can probably just sell your coins for 99 cents anyway. So Chainlink is definitely like taking a good and important part of the Oracle design space. And I'm definitely happy that there's like that project taking the task on. I mean, at the same time, I do think that, you know, their frog army on Twitter can get a bit intense at times, but
the frog army, is there a way to incorporate sort of Oracle network type of ideas into Ethereum?
I personally would prefer the Ethereum base layer, like stay away from trying to provide too much functionality, because like once you have the Ethereum base layer making a claim about, like, say, the US dollar to Ethereum price, like, and at some sense, you're basically saying that like Ethereum as a base platform starts making what could be geopolitical statements,
right?
Like, for example, you know, imagine if there was some, you know, civil war and the U.S. split up and you had two currencies that both claims to be the U.S. dollar. Well, you know, Ethereum would have to pick one for the sake of everyone who is already using that oracle. So, you know, does that mean that the blockchain would be like taking a position in this big mega political debate? So I think, like, for just those kinds of reasons, I would personally prefer Ethereum itself to be more of this sort of pure platform that just analyzes transactions just mathematically using deterministic consensus rules. And then if you need the oracles, that can be layer twos. Mm-hmm. Like, I think Ethereum benefits from not trying to do everything at layer one and having this like very robust layer two ecosystem where you have all these projects doing interesting things.
Yeah, focus on the basic technology, avoid the politics. Gotcha.